October is one of my favorite months of the year. The cool, crisp air, the gorgeous fall colors. I love pulling out my cashmere sweaters, and it is my birthday month. I will be turning 64 in just a couple of weeks, for which I am incredibly grateful. To celebrate my birthday month, I thought it would be fun to play with a little luxury makeup today. So we are going to play with the new-ish Natasha Denona I Need a Nude Eyeshadow Palette. I finally picked up the new Hourglass Face Palette, and we're also going to be playing with some new Rephr brushes that Rephr is launching October 17th for their 4-year anniversary sale. In the interest of time, I've already applied my corrector, concealer, foundation, tight line, and eyebrows, most of which are drugstore products, by the way. Anyway, everything is listed and linked in the description box below, as well as in a pinned comment and in the new YouTube shopping feature. Many of these links are affiliate, absolutely no pressure, but if you do choose to shop my links, I thank you. It really does help support my channel, and I very much appreciate it. Before we get into the actual makeup, I'm going to share a little bit about some of the Rephr brushes that I will be using and that will be launching on sale in just a couple of days. You know, Rephr is a company that makes the highest quality Japanese handcrafted natural bristle brushes, and they strive to make them available to the everyday consumer. Rephr has a very unique business model. What they will do is they will develop a prototype, offer it at a discounted rate in what they call their concept store, in exchange for honest feedback. They then use that feedback to create their final product, and anyone can participate in the concept store. Anyway, they've gotten tons of feedback on 5 of their most popular eyeshadow brushes. Some people want them in a smaller version, some people want them in a larger version. Their 5 most popular brushes, and I can only find 4, are the 01, the 02, the 13, the 14, which I can't find, and the 15. These are their very most popular eyeshadow brushes, and they will be launching a mini version and a maxi version on October 17th. So very quickly, I will show you the size differences in some of these brushes. So you can see definite size differences, although the shape and the texture of each brush is the same. And I think it's really cool that they did this rather than just making new numbers of brushes, so that you know if the O2 doesn't quite work for you and you wish it were a little smaller, there you go. Or you wish it were a little bigger, there you go. Let me quickly run through the other brushes. The 13, I use this brush all the time. I did clean my brushes in preparation for this video, and I also washed the new Rephr brushes. This is the number 13. It is a really small shader brush. There is the mini, and there is the maxi. Like I said, I cannot find my brush 14, so I'm not going to show you those. But the brush 15 is a nice medium-sized crease brush. Here is the mini, and here is the maxi. So once again, if any of these brushes, if you wish it were smaller, you wish it were larger, you are in luck. Like I said, these 2 new brush sets, the mini and the maxi, 5 eyeshadow brushes each, will be launching on Rephr's 4-year anniversary sale starting October 17th. Normally these brush sets will be $120, but during the anniversary sale, they will be offered at $60, which is an incredible deal. What is that, $12 each? Incredible price. Currently, these new brushes are only offered in a set, but I'm sure at some point they will be offered individually. Rephr is also launching a very special holiday face brush using extra soft bristles. And look at the detail painted on the handle. This brush will arrive in this beautiful wooden box. Now, this brush will be available during the anniversary sale at a discounted price. Now keep in mind, the anniversary sale, October 17th, is primarily for these new launches. There may be some other products available, but very limited, because Rephr is gearing up for their biggest sale of the year, which of course is Black Friday, where I believe it will be 50% off site-wide. So I am making my wish list for sure. The Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powders have been at the very top of my favorites. for years. Their formula is incredibly finely milled, super silky, and absolutely stunning on mature skin. I often say they put magic dust in their powders. And every year, Hourglass launches a holiday face palette. But I have never purchased one. Often the shades are duplicates of shades I already have, or the shades just aren't right for me. One color story just cannot meet everybody's needs. But this year, Hourglass finally launched three color stories. The lightest being Jellyfish, and then we have Leopard, and then we have Snake. Absolutely gorgeous packaging. And I am hitting serious pan on my finishing powder, so I will need to replace this at some point anyway. But I still wasn't sure until I started hearing from some of you how much you were loving it. And it's my birthday month, so Ulta gave me a 20% discount coupon and double points. So I finally picked up my first face palette, and I picked up the Jellyfish, which is the lightest version. And I have to say, I am absolutely loving it. Let's do some swatches. We have Rose Fusion, a beautiful berry, Diffused Heat, a lovely coral, Lunar Bronze, and Metallic Strobe Highlighter in Opal. And there they are. And here they are on my arm. Absolutely gorgeous. Now I will say, I do wish that instead of two finishing powders, which are very similar to each other, they had included three blushes. But if they do have to have two finishing powders, I also wish they would be right next to each other instead of on the opposite sides, so it would be easier for me to run my brush over both of them. But overall, I am really happy I treated myself to this palette. Let's get some of these on my face. Now, I've already set my foundation with the finishing powder. You really can't see finishing powder anyway. So we will go into the bronzer. And again, these are pretty pigmented, so I'm picking up just a small amount, tapping it off my arm. And let's do a little bit of bronzing action. You know, I really do like this bronzer. So often bronzers are too deep for me or too warm. And this is just a nice neutral bronze shade. Next, we'll do a little bit of blush, and I am going to use the Diffused Heat. Again, tap it off on my wrist. These are really pigmented and it's easy to overdo it. So a little bit of, ooh yeah, see, even when I tap it off, it is really, really quite pigmented. But super, super pretty. Love it. Now, if you do go in a little bit too heavy with a blush, you can pick up a little bit of the finishing powder and just sort of buff it out, blend it all together. Now this blush is already pretty radiant, so I actually don't need a highlighter, but I do want to show you this beautiful opal highlighter. It's pretty glimmery, so I'm gonna go in very lightly with my new Rephr brush because this is so soft. I'm just picking up a small amount, tapping it off and applying just very lightly to the top of my cheekbone. This is opal is a perfect description for the shade of this highlighter. Absolutely gorgeous. Let's talk price. This is definitely luxury at a whopping $90. But for comparison, the full-size powders run $45. Now, I have had this finishing powder for well over 4 years, and it is still going strong. Now, I usually do like to pick up the blushes in the mini. These last me at least a couple of years. And here is the size comparison, mini to the full size. Now, this palette has 6 mini sizes. If we were to purchase these minis individually, it would be $170. So compared to that, $90 doesn't sound so bad, but it is still a lot of money. So I am really happy that I had a 20% discount coupon. Happy birthday to me. Moving on to luxury eyeshadow. Now, up until now, I've only had two of the Natasha Denona eyeshadow palettes. I have the Glam and the Retro. Absolutely love her formula, but her launches the past few years really haven't tempted me. They've either been a little too deep or a little too warm. But the moment I saw I need a nude, I ordered it. At a whopping $69, I would normally wait for a sale, but in this case, I couldn't wait. This is perfect for me. Not too deep, not too warm, really very approachable with some really neutral shades, some cooler taupes, some slightly warmer rosy peaches, and a perfect complement to the deeper Natasha Denona Glam, as well as Natasha Denona Retro. Now, I have used the heck out of this since I got it. It is so easy to do, an easy everyday look. I'm not going to swatch these. This has been out a while. There are tons of really good review videos, good swatch videos. I will link Kiki's video in the description box below. I think she did two beautiful looks and really good swatches, so check out Kiki's video. Anyway, today I'm going to do my go-to fast, easy, everyday look. I'm going to start with this matte shade called Fair using my Rephr 01. And I'm just going to dust this all over the lid, lashes to brow, just to even out my lid and set my concealer. I really do love that they included this shade because it is a great blending shade. Next, I'm going to take this matte taupe called Mesh. This is a perfect transition shade. And I'm just going to dust that very lightly, slightly above my crease and into the socket and on the outer corner using my Rephr 16 brush. I really love this shade as a transition shade. I am going to take my new Rephr 15 Min, and I'm going to pick up Stone and Tender just to deepen up the socket and the outer corner just a little bit. Now, I always keep a clean blending brush, and my favorite one is the Rephr 27. Yeah, that's the 27. Just make sure everything meshes beautifully together. Now, I always enjoy a little bit of shimmer on my lid, so I'm going to take my new Rephr 02 Max, and I'm going to pick up a little bit of this shade here called Filigree, and I'm going to put this on the outer half of my mobile lid just for a little bit of sheen. And then taking my original Rephr 02 flat shader brush into this shade called Whisper, just a really nice sort of champagne taupe shimmer. And that is going to go on the inner half of my eyelid. And there is the eyeshadow look. I'm going to go off camera, do my mascara and my eyeliner, and then we will come back and finish up with lips. Finishing up with lipstick, my number one favorite makeup category. So I was very excited when Sigma sent me all five of their brand new lip creams. Now, in comparison to the other products that I'm sharing with you today, these seem relatively affordable at $22. And I do have a discount code listed in the description box below. I did swatch these on my arm for you. The first one is Dapper, which is a warm hibiscus shade. Then we have Begonia, a blush pink. Rosewood, which is a rosewood shade. New Mod, which is a mauve shade, and Dusty Rose, which actually looks to me to be a little bit deeper than a Dusty Rose. Really beautiful shades. Very pigmented formula. Now, I am going to link Mary Glitzy Fritzy's video in the description box below because she lip swatched every single one of these shades. Anyway, it's a lip cream, and it comes with a doe foot applicator, which is a little bit on the large size for me to be super accurate with my lip color. So I am going to line my lips with my Milani Nude just to help keep the lip cream within my lip lines. And today I am going to use the shade Rosewood. Anyway, there is Sigma, the new lip cream in the shade Rosewood. I think it is a beautiful formula, very pigmented, very moisturizing, and surprisingly long lasting for a lip cream. And here is the final look. I have to say, I have been really enjoying all of these products. As usual, everything on my face is listed and linked in the description box below. And I do want to apologize for the way the light keeps changing throughout the video. It's a partly cloudy day, so I have to keep getting up and raising and lowering the shades. And many of you have asked for an update on my move to upstate New York. As you can see, I'm still staying with my cousins. My cousin is working on the new tiny cottage, but progress is a little bit slow because he can only work on it on the weekends. So my goal is to be into my new tiny cottage before Christmas. Stay tuned, I will be posting sort of video updates of the progress and of course the finished result. And with that, have yourself a great day, a wonderful week, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you, bye.